This is General Counsel Studio, and I'm your host, Andrew Zezas. I have the pleasure of being joined today by Mr. Craig Bleifer, Vice President, General Counsel, and Secretary at Daiichi Sankyo, Inc. Mr. Bleifer is one of the first recipients of the 2012 NJBiz General Counsel of the Year Award. He recently wrote an article that appeared in Corporate Counsel magazine entitled, 10 Questions CEOs Should Ask GCs About the Legal Business Plan. Craig's been Chief Legal Officer at Daiichi Sankyo since 2000 and has practiced law for over 20 years. Daiichi Sankyo is a $1.5 billion pharmaceutical company based here in New Jersey, focused on cardiovascular medicine and oncology. It's the U.S. operation of a 100-year-old Japanese pharmaceutical company that, in and of itself, is among the top 20 in the world. Craig's here today to talk to us about profit, risk, and the legal business plan. Craig, it's wonderful to have you here on General Counsel Studio.
Thanks, Andy. Glad to be here.
Craig, your article, 10 Questions CEOs Should Ask GCs About the Legal Business Plan. Why is a legal business plan so important these days?
You know, a legal business plan is really important in terms of being part of a larger business plan that integrates the legal strategies right into the business strategies. It's also really important for the legal function itself to have something that they're accountable for, and also it demonstrates to the business the value that they're adding. You know, when I first started working in-house and I was leaving the law firm that I was working for, one of my colleagues said to me, "This is great. You've got it easy now. You're going in-house. You're going to have an office right in the company. And, you know, we kill to get in there. And you're going to be right in there. Those clients are going to be knocking on the door. They're going to be lining up to meet you."
No marketing, and, no effort, catcher's mitt.
Right. No more selling, no more marketing, no more client contact. You know, you're just going to have a ton of work to do. And, you know, he couldn't have been more wrong. That became obvious pretty quickly after I started. You know, you do have to market and sell yourself. Now, not in a glossy, flashy way, but it's really more about demonstrating the value that you and your department bring to the company. And really, a legal business plan, apart from being a key business function of the entire corporation, is part of the way that the legal department can explain to the corporation the value that it does bring all year long throughout the operations.
And I'm sure a component of a legal business plan is typically inspiring parallel departments to not just view the legal department as, you know, rear view facing, and to inspire them to be more integrated with the legal department and to permit the legal department to in turn be more integrated with them.
Well, yeah. I mean, a good legal department and a good legal business plan are completely connected to whatever the business operations are and whatever the business strategies are. You know, if the legal department and the legal business plan are some sort of abstract, some sort of academic exercise that only really the lawyers know about, then people don't understand what you're about, they don't understand who you are, and the business, you know, might view you as just some sort of overhead, maybe a kind of an annoying, necessary place that you need to go to get things approved. You know, and at worst, you know, that would be called the sales prevention department.
Sales prevention department, I love it.
You don't want to be in that position. You want to be part of the business itself. That's why you would want to come work for a company in the first place. And it's a lot of fun.
I can imagine if done right, it's got to be a lot of fun. So respecting that any business plan can take on different shapes and sizes, what would you say would be the most important components of a solid legal business plan?
Yeah. So one of the first components that's easy to overlook is the obvious. There's the day-to-day operational legal processes and activities that have to happen every year, no matter what the strategy is. So there's kind of a back office aspect to that. It's reviewing contracts. It's approving materials. It's preparing technical documents. But there should be a part of the business plan that focuses on that in terms of, not that it's anything new or exciting, but making sure that in each year it's done really well,
right.
It's done efficiently, and there's some sort of measurement in terms of knowing that you're doing a good job, even in those operational things. It's kind of like, you know, keeping the lights on.
Right.
You know, when one light bulb goes out, everybody notices, right? And it's the same thing with the legal department. When you've got a few late contracts or a few items that people have difficulty with, it doesn't go well. So your plan should really be built around making sure that operationally you have a really good, solid, efficient way of doing that business.
So that's the nuts and bolts part.
Right. That's nuts and bolts. Now, the other parts of a legal business plan are more strategic in terms of what we were just talking about, right? So one thing, one big bucket that comes to mind is litigation. So litigation, whether it's offensive or defensive, still has to be strategic. So sometimes the litigation just comes to you. You don't ask for it. You didn't, you know, prepare for it. It's a surprise. There's nothing you can do but do a good job in defending it. Well, the legal business plan should really spell out how you're going to actually defend the case. Are you going to do it inside? Are you going to do it outside? What are your resources? How are you going to keep costs down? How are you going to make sure that your strategy in handling that case is going to be somehow tied to the business strategy? The other side could be offensive, and litigation can be used as a business tool. Now, it depends on what kind of business you're in. It depends on what kind of opportunities there are. It could be as simple as a dispute with a vendor or a third party where you can stand up and say, hey, we're right. We're going to bring an action and claim money for some damage that was done to us or for some right we have. Or it could be even more strategic in terms of, let's say, patent litigation, where you're really clearing a path for you to enter into a new market. Okay. So in terms of the strategic side, the kind of opposite of litigation would be risk management.
Right.
So that's another really important part of what a legal function does, and it's a really important part of what a good business plan does. So it's easy to say, well, that's what the legal people do all day long. They counsel us, they help us. So what would the plan be? Just keep doing it. Well, right. Yes.
Yes and no.
And no. So there should be some sort of plan about this year. Well, what are we going to be counseling on? What are we going to be focusing on? And maybe what's the customer service that goes along with that to make sure we're doing a good job. The last one is maybe the most highly strategic, depending on your circumstances. If you've got the kind of company that has the resources and the willpower, you might want to go beyond the counseling on the legal environment that you're in and risk managing against that, but try and, through the legal function, have an impact and change the environment you're in the first place. So normally this is done through a government affairs function. It should be tied closely to the legal function wherever that function reports in the company. And the point is to take a look at the environment around you as it's developing and at a minimum be reactive. Defend against bad laws, bad regulations that are coming your way that might hurt your business. Know that they're coming. Talk to the business about what's coming. Find out whether it's important to them. And if it is and they say, oh no, this would be terrible, well then you need to put some legal manpower behind that, maybe some lobbying resources behind that, and try and influence that decision. It goes the other way, too, in terms of the offense. If you know your business well enough, you can, through your knowledge of the laws and regulations, seek opportunities to maybe open up markets, open up opportunities. Talk to your business people about, well, I wish the rule was this. Well, maybe we can change that rule. Now, you can't get too optimistic about that. There's always the political realities you're faced with. But if you're smart and you have a plan, you can, you know, take small, effective pieces on in a plan and really affect change that has, you know, an effect right back on the bottom line of the business, because it changes the whole environment that your business is operating in.
So you just gave me four pillars. So let me repeat them. You said, first of all, it's nuts and bolts lawyering.
Right.
It's and the operational side. Litigation would be the second one. Risk management would be the third. And then the legal environment would be the fourth.
Correct.
Okay, those are the four pillars of a good, solid legal business plan. Perfect. Makes perfect sense.
I think so. It gives you a holistic approach of not only affecting the environment you're in, but operating to the maximum capacity within it.
Okay, so you mentioned earlier that having a good legal business plan can't be this exercise, this theoretical exercise, I think was the term you used. So how important does it become for the general counsel to gain not just buy-in, but input in the process of creating and developing a good legal business plan?
Yeah, it's key. If you don't have internal client input into your plan baked in, you don't really have a very good plan.
Because that just becomes theoretical.
It's theoretical. It's academic. It's something that people won't understand. It's something that people wouldn't be able to support financially even. You know, why are we going to fund this project? We don't understand what it is. Oh, well, it's legally important. That's not going to usually sell the day. It's not usually going to be something that makes sense for the business. So what you need to do as the general counsel is you personally and your team, however big it is, need to fan out in the company and talk to your key clients. Now, this should happen all year long. That's good customer service. But especially when it's business plan time, talk to them as they're preparing their business plans, not when it's done. Talk to them while they're in the middle of it. Find out what
they're preparing their plans.
Right. Talk to them about what they are thinking about doing next year. Understand what that is as far upstream as you can. Find out what the challenges are that they're facing in the marketplace. Find out what the opportunities are and the threats that they see. And make sure that you are going to be able to support them. Now, on a really, really good day, not only will you support them in the back office, not only will you, you know, review all the material, not only will you defend against the things in the environment that are a known risk, but on a really good day, you'll sit down with the business people and talk about some affirmative things that you can do, which are the things that we were just talking about, whether it's some sort of lobbying project, whether it's some sort of affirmative litigation, whether it's some sort of, you know, creative counseling that might be necessary for the business. If there's, let's say, a new marketing technique that you're going into, get out there. Understand what it is. Maybe there is legal issues there that your group has never dealt with before. Well, if there is, you better learn about it. You better study it. You better then teach it to your client and make sure that they're ready before they get into that business, not afterwards and you're cleaning up some kind of mess.
Craig, in terms of risk mitigation, how does a legal business plan serve to positively change the risk profile either of a company as a whole or just a business unit?
Yeah, so it's really important that the business plan focuses on specific activities that the legal function is going to engage in during the year to improve the risk profile of the company. So it's easy to say that, you know, every lawyer's job is to manage risk. Okay, but that's not a plan. How are we going to do it?
Right.
And it's not this simple, well, every day someone comes in my office and we talk. That's not a plan, okay? Right. So a plan is getting really tactical. So one good example and one thing that I really like to focus on in the realm of risk management is education. So it's having a plan that, for example, says that we know now as the legal function in the company that there is a risk area of our business, right? And in order to mitigate against that risk, we need to properly educate the business people about what the issues are and the risks are and the rules of the road, and maybe even the internal company procedures, right?
Right?
A business plan from a legal function would say, we're going to teach the following specific courses, these two in the first quarter, this one in the third quarter, and so on, and be really clear and specific so that the business knows what's expected of them. After all, we're going to ask them to spend some time in these courses, right? But also so that it's something that you as a department and as a general counsel can be accountable for at the end of the year. We said we were going to deliver 5 educational programs. We did 6, and they went really well. You know, that's a business plan. Mm. It's not just this vague idea of, oh, yeah, we risk manage. Oh, yeah, we educate people. But it's a real laying out in advance of, here's what I commit.
Like any good business plan.
Exactly.
Like any good business plan. Let's talk about growth and profits because, you know, the idea of the legal team getting involved in supporting the company's growth, it's foreign to many people, but certainly not to your organization. How does a legal business plan proactively support the growth and profitability of a company?
Yeah, so it really goes back to what I was saying before. It's the idea of making sure that the legal function understands the business, not just the law. Mm-hmm. You know, understanding the law for the lawyers.
Say that again, understands.
The business.
Not just
the law. Because
that's very astute.
You know, you should really kind of take it for granted that your lawyers know the law. That shouldn't be a question, right? If you have that question, you've got whole other problems. And of course, you have to make sure that people do know the law through having the right credentials and having ongoing education, but that's in the background. Mm-hmm. What's most important for the success of a legal department and therefore the success of the company is that the lawyers get the business. Mm-hmm. If they're abstract, if they're disconnected, they're never going to be able to provide the right kind of legal service. So it's a question of having the lawyers deeply knowledgeable, deeply involved about how things really work in the company, how they could work, how they might work, and again, knowing what the business plans, hopes, dreams are of the line management of the company so that you can be a partner with them, an integrated partner with them, no matter how highly regulated your industry may be. At the end of the day, there should be a legal element to a business plan, and the point is to get it baked right into the strategy so that it's not looked at as some separate kind of overhead thing. It's actually part and parcel of the way everybody breathes and thinks and does business every day. That's kind of the ideal.
Is it fair to say that that from the legal department's perspective, or at least from your legal department's perspective, that it's not about the law, but it's about knowing how to utilize the law to generate growth and profits?
It is. At the end of the day, you know, you're there working for the company. You're not, I mean, it's kind of obvious, but you're not working for the governments that regulate you. Right. You're not working for the competitors. Right. You're working to advance the business. So lawyers sometimes forget that. And it's easy to forget that and get all wrapped up inside of a legal
sure.
issue about the way something should be. Sure. And, you know, some rules are the rules. And it's really, really important that you, as a legal function, are that voice in the company. It's very crucial. But at the end of the day, all of that has to be in service of the business being successful.
Right.
So you don't want to be the sales prevention department, like I said, but if you're managing risk, it can't just be the hammer coming down and you saying no. It better be in an environment where the business understands why it might be no, and then the challenge and the best day, a good day for a lawyer, is when you get beyond no, and if it's possible, you get creatively into, well, how else might we do something?
Right. Craig, we're almost out of time. I have time for one more question.
Sure.
Let's talk about measurement quickly if we can. How can a company measure whether or not a legal business plan is having a positive effect on the business? Because we're talking about growth and profits. How do you measure that?
Yeah, well, you know, a good business plan should have some sort of metrics. A legal business plan should also have metrics. Now, it's a little bit hard because the nature of the legal function isn't susceptible of a hard and fast metric like sales and profitability.
Right, right.
But you can build in operational metrics, let's say even on those nuts and bolt things. What's your volume of work per head? What's your turnaround time? Are you improving on that? A little bit softer, but maybe just as important, getting back to customer service. That's something that's measurable. You know, you can and you should go out there and when you talk to your customers, ask them how you're doing. And you can collect that. You can do an informal survey. You can do a formal survey where you literally field questions and it's anonymous and people fill in the blanks and you take the data and you analyze how are you doing with this department versus that department, how'd you do versus last year, how do people feel about you, and then you report that back not only to management but back to your own team, because when you report it back to your own team, there's going to be positives, there's going to be negatives. And whatever those negatives are or areas for improvement, that goes right into next year's business plan.
Sure.
That's the way it should work.
Craig, this has been great. You've got some wonderful ideas, and I'm certain that Daiichi Sankyo is benefiting from your very progressive approach to running the legal department. I want to thank you here for being on. Thank you for being here on General Counsel Studio. I hope you'll come back and see us again.
Thanks. I've enjoyed it.
It's been great.
Bye now.
This is Andrew Zezas, your host at General Counsel Studio, saying thank you very much for watching. We'll see you again.